one's called E-Notes, but this one is called...
N-A-R-K.
A lot of people seem to have them.
Yeah.
But they're just cheap.
Test it while you got a chance and see if it picks up good on your banjo, because that's a different situation.
Both our batteries are about...
What kind of batteries do you take?
CR-2032.
It's a 3202 or something. It's what every other tuner takes.
Oh, okay. Because it's kind of easy to find those.
Not done for you.
Uh-oh. I think it's that just stamps on.
It's nice and swivelly.
That's what I like about them, because of the different shaped pegheads on the banjos. Some I have to turn up and down.
Right.
This is a nice tuner, but I can't put it on top because I can't get this head to come around. So it has to go facing the bottom.
What kind is that?
Yeah, this IntelliTouch. It's a nice sensitive one. It's just hard to see on a banjo. Of course, fine on guitar. That works for beans on your dulcimer.
Oh, really?
Boy, that works.
Should we have it grow before it works?
Is that any better? Or?
Yeah.
Sort of like that. Yeah.
It's more accurate that way.
It's the battery.
Thank you.
5A, I want you to cross tune. That's not word management.
No. That's not
that.
And because it'll tear up my bow, which I can no longer get properly repaired.
Really?
Uh-huh.
It has to do it like this.
Yeah, you have to. And I'm not doing it because I've had this year in this bow for probably 10 years. And we've tried getting some other people to fill other bows, and they're not as good. And this one is on its last go around.
That would do it.
So you have a new bow?
Well, I've got spare bows, but this one is better balanced. And we're going to have to go to those disposable fiberglass bows, which cost less than it costs to get one repaired. So,
where did you go?
We went down to Lambsburg. Right.
Got a guy in the field. What, 4 foot?
Two. Was it two?
No.
Three, maybe.
Three.
Okay. That was Richard's recommendation, but Betty Hornbrock said to go to, where was that place? It was down in North Carolina somewhere, and they said that he would keep it for a month or two until he got around to it. So,
meantime, you don't have a
bow. Meantime, you use his travel bows. And
there's a guy, he's real low, I don't know where he comes
from. Oh, yeah. He's the one that filled this.
He's the best one.
Yes. Right.
Did you ever go to the fiddler conventions and work there?
Yes, that's what we did.
Oh,
yeah.
Great.
That's what I got.
They get a lot of business there.
Yeah, they just work from home. We can't stand him. Yeah. But he's got so old, he's like this.
Yeah. Got to be a real art.
Yeah, there is.
All the hair is the exact same tension and the
yes.
tension.
Yeah.
Well, you got to turn. Work. Got to turn half off one way and the other half the other way.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't know that.
Yeah, if you don't get it in there just right, it'll start coming out one hair at a time until the whole thing loosens up and it goes.
But if you don't turn
right.
around,
it'll only play in one direction.
Half on one way and half the other way. See, you only have one way that it'll grab a string.
Yeah. Well, I
didn't know that. And the little grab things on the hair, the little scales on the hair will wear out after a while. That's what happens with this one.
About how long does it take?
I don't know, like they're saying, that's 10 years, right. And I'm still on the same way.
plays Danio and Featherweight Lake is the same tune, but it's different.
What key do they play Danio in?
Same key. It's a melody.
There's a few tunes that we can't play both of because it's
yes.
So, just drop one.